Let's start with a random rectangle, and then in it we will inscribe the half circle at the certain random angle. So in that way we will form the right triangle at the right side of the rectangle, and that right triangle will have the legs of 10 and 24. The question is, can we find this orange shaded area with the information given? If you want to answer this one for yourself and try it out, you can pause the video right now and then come back to see the solution. Alright, let's get to the solution. So, first thing that we're going to do is we're going to notice this blue right triangle at the right side of our rectangle. And we're going to label this right triangle as A, B and C. Now, you can see that we can use the Pythagorean theorem for this one. We can say that the hypotenuse AB squared must be equal to the leg BC squared plus the leg AC squared. So we're going to substitute our values and get the following. From here, we're going to simplify this even more, and we're going to get that AB squared is equal to 676. Of course, we're going to find the square root of that, and we're going to get that the line AB is equal to 26. As you can see, this line also represents the diameter of our half circle. Now, we will mark the center of our half circle as O. Then we will pull the vertical line upward from the point O to the upper side of our rectangle, and we're going to mark this intersection as D. You can notice that at the point D we also have the right angle. In this way, you can see that we have formed another right triangle, OBD. Now, let's take a look at its hypotenuse, OB. This hypotenuse will be equal to the radius of our half circle. Since the diameter is equal to 26, that means that the line OB must be equal to 13. Now, let's try to work with these two right triangles. You can see that both of them share the same angle at the point B. And since both of them are right triangles, we can conclude that their third angle must also be congruent. That means that these two triangles OBD and ABC are similar triangles. So we can use this in our favor to try to find the factor of similarity between those two triangles. And since we have the value of the hypotenuse of both of these triangles, we can divide this value to get that the similarity factor between those two triangles is equal to 2 in this case. That means that the sides of our smaller green triangle are actually twice smaller than the sides of our bigger blue right triangle. So, with that in mind, we can conclude that the leg BD of our smaller triangle must be equal to 5, and the leg OD must be equal to 12. Alright, now let's head back to our previous sketch. Let's notice that the line BD has the length of 5, and since the line BC has the length of 10, that means that the line DC must also have the length of 5. Now, let's rotate our radius OB to the intersection point between the arc of our circle and the left side of the rectangle. You can notice that the angle that this radius forms with the right side of the rectangle is 90 degrees. But how do we know this? Well, we know this by using the tangent of a circle theory. Just to remind you, this theorem states that if we have a circle and the tangent line, and if we pull a radius from the center of our circle to the intersection point between the tangent line and the circle, the angle between our radius and the tangent line will always be 90 degree angle. So we are just using this theorem in our case here, since the left side of the rectangle is a tangent line to our half circle. The same thing will apply if we rotate the radius vertically. You can see that this time the bottom side of our rectangle represents the tangent to our half circle, so that angle must also be 90 degree angle. Alright, now Let's notice that our horizontal radius is equal to 13 and the line DC is equal to 5. So we can slide those two sides down and we will form the base of our rectangle, which is equal to 18. The same thing will apply for the height of our rectangle. You can again notice the vertical radius is equal to 13 and you can notice that the line OD is equal to 12. So if we slide it to the right, you can see that the height of our rectangle is equal to 25. Now it's pretty easy for us to find this orange shaded area. Since we know that this orange area must be equal to the area of our orange rectangle minus the area of our half circle and minus the area of our right triangle. So we can substitute our values. We can say that the orange area is equal to the area of the rectangle, which is equal to the base times height, in this case that is 18 times 25, minus the area of our half circle, which is equal to the 1/2 of the radius squared pi, and minus the area of our right triangle, that is equal to the half of the product of its legs, in this case that is 10 times 24 over 2. Now we can simplify this to get to the following. And if we simplify it more, we will get that our orange area is equal to 330 minus 169 pi over 2. Of course, we can simplify this to get that our orange shaded area is approximately equal to 64.5 squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, write it down in the comment section below. And as always, until next time, see you guys and take care.